telling you about. Oh. They are so huge. Well, I'll fit in there. Inside, it's dry and it smells really good. It's so nice. I found them yesterday when I happened to be passing by. At first, I didn't even see the entrance, but when I walked around the whole thing, I saw the other two caves as well. Lars is out there looking for something new to play with, too. I have to tell him about the new cave. He's gonna be so excited.
Wait, peeps! Don't you want to have a look inside first?
Later! I gotta find Lars!
Well, then I guess I'll just have to check it out myself.
Looks like we're off to a great start today. We've already got one in here. Well, it's off to the sled with you.
Well, can't be a very big one. It's pretty light.
Lars, I found something.
What is it?
Really, really, really great caves. You have to see them. Huh? You won't believe it.
Yeah, that sounds exciting.
But Lars, you have to come right away or they'll disappear again. It's not far. We're gonna have great caves.
Building so many channels. It's very beautiful up here.
Yeah, but down here it's very pretty too.
Lars is going to love this place, that's for sure.
Look, there they are. But that's strange. There were three of them before. It's okay. Two are enough for us. Anna's not here anymore either. I guess she didn't want to wait. Hmm? Hey, Lars, look what else is here.
Huh?
It's a very strange-looking polar bear. My name's Peeps. What's your name? Is it okay if we look at your cave?
Hey!
Whoa! Weird. There used to be a polar bear here. Hey, let's go inside. The caves are empty, and they smell so good, like an adventure.
No, something just doesn't feel right. I'm not going in.
But it's so wonderful in here. You have to at least take a look. Look, nothing bad happened. Someone just built the most wonderful caves in the world for us.
Okay, then the other one's mine.
Sure, Lars. I'll go get the others. I'll be right back.
Something's in the other trap.
Let's see what we've got this time. I don't see anything.
That's impossible. The trap was closed.
The trigger must be broken.
Are you sure about that?
Well, of course I'm sure. I'm looking right at it. Here.
Careful! What are you thinking? Wait, I'll help you.
Thanks.
Now the trigger's working fine.
This one's empty.
Yeah, well, I can't exactly sell you to the zoo.
Huh?
Let's see what's in this one. Great. A little polar bear.
They must be here somewhere. The only ones who could have built caves like that are Robbie and Greta.
Here you go.
I always thought snow geese knew how to swim.
Well, not if they're really scared. Oh, yeah, Lars is in danger.
I've never seen anything like that before. A huge trap. We gotta help him.
Well, let's go.
But hardly anything for the mountain hare.
Yeah, this one's quite heavy. Give it a push. Here, give me the rope.
Here.
Let's get back to camp.
Yeah, let's go. I'm sure the airplane is waiting for us.
Hey, I thought I heard something. I guess it was nothing. Let's go.
Look, they're taking Lars away. We have to rescue him.
We have to follow them.
I know how we can find them. See, here are the tracks they left behind. If we follow the tracks, we'll find Lars. Come on, let's help him.
One box in the airplane.
Well, the polar bear or the mountain rabbit? Which one do you want?
Well, naturally, it's the polar bear.
What is that thing?
Whoa!
Hey, you in there. You're next. Your plane leaves tomorrow. All right, I'm gonna hit the hay.
I've never heard Lars cry like that before.
I'm sure it's very dark in there for him.
We have to rescue Lars.
Yeah, but how?
I could try to fly over the fence.
And then what, peeps? No, what we need to do is come up with a really good plan.
Maybe we'll find a hole somewhere.
Lars, the little polar bear.
Sophocles? They got you too?
Yes, yes. Don't waste time with questions. Help me get out of here first.
Yeah, okay, but how am I supposed to do that?
All you have to do is open the latch with your paw. Good job there, little Lars.
Where are we anyway, Sophocles?
This place is a camp for trapped animals. But now we can free ourselves, and then go home.
Yeah, home.
But we must not forget the rest of the animals here. They're all in those boxes.
Huh? You really think there are other animals in there?
Sure, and you and I are now going to free them all.
Okay, let's do it.
We must watch out and be certain that nobody gets hurt. We must not forget any boxes. So far, we've freed the raccoon, the snow owl, the moose, the fox, and the beaver. This box here is the only one that's left.
I'll open it.
Thank you. I'm Leah Brown Bear.
You're really a bear?
Mm-hmm.
But you're not even white.
I'm a girl bear. By the way, bears are never white.
All bears are white so that they're able to hide in the snow.
Not true. I said all bears are brown. Huh? If they weren't brown, they wouldn't be able to hide in the forest.
The fact of the matter is, you're each right. You're both bears. One is white, and the other is brown. It's going to be dark soon, and if the two of you don't stop arguing about it, none of us will ever get out of here. I've found an open window. You have to crawl through it and open the gate.
Hey, wait, I know how to open the gate.
Yes, we have to hurry. Wait for me! Come on, we'll jump. Hey, there's a slide.
It's easier to slide on ice. Okay, climb on my back and push that red thing. The gate will open.
Stop moving.
Now I got it.
They're sure in a big hurry.
And they are right. We have to get out of here, too. Off into the bushes.
We can only get in if we go through the water.
Yeah, I know, but I've never jumped off a cliff that was this high before.
Don't be afraid. It's easy. I'll show you.
Okay, whoa! I'll try it.
And I'll fly over the fence.
Come on, Greta, jump. There you go. You did it.
I'll keep watch from here.
Watch out, Sophocles, the floodlight!
I'm coming! That was very close.
Hey, guys, I want to go home right now. But it's so far from here.
Yes, Leah, the forest is far.
Well, do you know how to get there?
We brown bears always know how to find our way home. All we have to do is feel it.
We polar bears have the North Star. We just have to follow it.
Yes, Lars, that's how you get to your home, the North Pole. Leah's forest is far away, all the way behind the snow line. We can only get there in the spring. Sorry, Leah, but you'll need to stay with us at the North Pole for the rest of the winter.
Well, what is that? The North Pole.
The North Pole's my home. That's where my friends live. And I'm sure you can stay with us, just until spring.
Are all bears there as white as you are? And can I live there too? A brown bear with the white bears?
Sure, a bear's a bear.
Well, finally you two agree. But now we have to get out of here, through the dam to the Arctic Sea.
That was easy, huh?
I'll do anything for Lars.
Oh, heard something.
Hey, watch out! Somebody's coming!
Stop crying and go to sleep already, scaredy cat.
Hey, do you hear that? It sounds like it's really close.
I hope the human isn't coming back.
I smell water.
Leah, it appears you're right. That is a waterway.
That was great, Leah. Did you really smell the water?
Yeah, of course I did.
Okay, come on, you two. Climb on my back, but be careful.
I can swim by myself.
Come on up here, Lars. It's nice and cozy.
If you say so.
Fine, let's get started.
Yeah! This is fun!
You better get going. The coast is clear.
That must be the box that Lars was caught in. Can you open it?
I can try. I saw the human lift up on this part of it right here.
Lars!
Lars?
Oh, Anna!
Lars isn't here! They took him with them!
Well, we've come to the first dam. Hold on tight.
What are we gonna do, Sophocles?
We're going to break through. I once lost my long tooth doing something like that.
But not this time.
Someone's coming. Oh, no.
Hey, what is that?
I can't swim.
It's okay. Hop on my back. Quick. Hey, we'll meet up behind the hill, okay?
Whoa!
This is the biggest dam there is. I've seen it before on some of my long journeys. We're going to have to wait until it opens.
Hey, look, it's moving.
Then we can move. I'm afraid that was a bit too close for me.
Hey, you want to know what?
What?
This is salt water. We're in the ocean.
All right.
Yeah, we made it. They can't get us way out here. Right?
And what about Lars? When is he going to come home?
I'm sure Lars has managed to free himself by now and is already on his way home.
You really think so?
Well, I hope so.
Huh?
Oh.
Last stop, the North Pole.
Thank you, Sophocles. We sure wouldn't have made it without you.
Be sure to come and see me sometime. We'll have some fish.
We'll be able to see everything from here. This is the North Pole, my home.
Ooh, it's so beautiful.
Lars! Lars!
Peeps, there you are.
Finally, I found you, Lars. The others are all waiting for you down below. And who is that?
This is Leah. Come on, Leah. You have to meet my friends.
Lars is here. Lars is here. And he brought someone with him.
We're so glad that you're back. We were worried about you.
I'm really glad, too. Oh, this is Leah. We've traveled a long way together. She's staying with us until spring.
Whoa, a brown bear?
Not every bear is white, you know.
It doesn't matter. We can all play together.
But first, I want to go see my parents. I have to introduce them to Leah. But we'll see you tomorrow.
You betcha.
Bye, you two. So long.
Oh, Mika, come on out here. Look, our Lars is back. Our son has returned home.
Mama! Papa!
Oh, Lars, we were so worried about you.
Can you tell us where you've been all this time?
I'll tell you in a minute, but first you have to meet someone I met on my journey. This is Leah. She's from the forest, and Sophocles helped us to get away from the poachers. She can only get home in the spring. Can she stay with us?
Of course she can. A bear is a bear.
She's not just a bear, Papa. Her name is Leah.
Too fast.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Lars! Leah!
What is that? Whoa!
Hey, Lars, do you know what that means? Spring is almost here!
Yeah! Yippee!
Yes, spring is nearly here!
Do you really think so?
Leah, watch out!
Spring! This is springtime! Lars, do you understand what that means?
Yeah, it means it's time for you to go back to the forest!
Yes, in the winter, the way back was way too dangerous for me, but now I finally get to go home again!
Does that mean you're leaving forever?
Yeah. I think that's what it means.
Can I come with you?
No, Peeps. That's way too dangerous and too far.
Oh, sure. It's always the same. Huh. Too far for little Peeps. Too far. Way too far. Well.
Really? And this year I thought that spring would never come.
Actually, I can smell the spring.
Do you know what that means?
Warm air, the icebergs will split, and the seagulls will be annoying.
Well, I was actually thinking of something else. Leah and I escaped from the poachers.
That's right. And she stayed with us because we asked her if she would like to stay here until the winter was over.
That's right, and now it's springtime.
The paths have all cleared, and I can be on my way home again.
Yes, of course. You must be very happy.
I really like it here and everything, but my home is in the forest.
I know. There's no place like home, is there?
All right, then we will bring you home, Leah. But not just today. I'm not exactly feeling very well. Good night.
Oh. What's wrong?
We just have to get a little more rest. It won't be long. We will have to find Sophocles first. He knows the way.
We can look for Sophocles.
Hey there! Hello, you two. I was wondering what time you would both get here.
What do you mean? You're waiting for us?
Well, sure. The icebergs are splitting. The seagulls are getting frisky. You know what that means. Spring is coming. And it's time for the little brown bear to go back to her home in the forest.
Sophocles, could you show us the way to the forest?
I'm already on it. Lars, that drawing is your ice cave. From here, you've got to go over the mountain, down to the snow line.
But what is the snow line?
Now don't be scared, it doesn't hurt. The snow simply stops there. Lars will find it if he follows his polar bear instinct.
And then?
Then you're going to have to trust your instincts, Leah. You need to cross a river, and once you do, you'll soon come upon the first trees. When you find that, that's the forest. But the journey is long and rather dangerous. You have to rely on each other.
Thanks,
Sophocles.
See ya. Bye.
Good luck, you two.
I wonder what Lars and Leah are up to.
Lars! Leah! Come quick!
What's wrong?
I think something is wrong with your parents.
They're not feeling very well today.
Don't worry. It's not that bad. I think we just need a little more time to rest, and then we can get going.
What did Sophocles say?
We know the way now, but what's wrong with you?
We're fine. We're just a little tired is all.
That's not just a little tired.
Lars, your parents are really sick. They have a bad bear flu, and there's no medicine for that. There's no way they can go on a long journey.
So what do we do then? We have to find a way to help them get better now.
There's something in our forest that helps every time.
What?
It's the honey medicine.
The honey medicine?
The honey medicine heals everything. And real quick, too. But it exists only in the forest. Lars has to bring me home.
Mm-hmm. But I can't leave my parents here like this.
Of course you can, Lars. You don't have a choice. Your parents have to get the honey medicine soon, don't they?
I've heard about the honey medicine on my long journeys. You'll have to go without me, I'm afraid.
Will you be able to find the way?
Sophocles told us everything we need to do.
Don't worry. In the meantime, we'll take care of your parents. Go on back into your cave. Come on, or you'll never get better.
We'll handle everything here, okay? But try to be back real soon.
And don't forget the honey medicine either.
Of course not.
All right, goodbye, Mama. Bye, Papa. See you soon.
Bye.
Hurry back, Lars.
And be careful.
Huh?
Bye. What are you doing outside? Come on, quick! Back inside, will you?
See way over there? That must be the snow line.
Do you remember what Sophocles said?
He said to go behind the snow line, cross a river, and find the forest.
What are we waiting here for? Your parents need the honey medicine right away.
Mm-hmm.
Come on.
This seaweed scarf is really quite comforting. Thank you, Greta.
Mika, you have quite a fever. The icicle is melting way too fast.
What are we going to do? They don't want to eat anymore.
Robbie brought all that fish for them, and now they won't even touch it.
I got something that'll help for sure. That's our sacred blubber. That works miracles.
Oh, I feel so much better already.
You are doing such a wonderful job looking after us. We'll be better in no time, even without the honey medicine. And Lars will be back soon.
Come on, Lars. Come on. This is my land. It may not be white, but it's just as solid as that.
Yeah, okay, I know. Are you sure your land is firm enough even in the spring?
Of course.
Hey, Lars! Stand back! Careful! This is the end of the North Pole!
This is none of your business.
Everything is your business! That is the snow line, and we are the guardians of it!
Lars, don't pay attention to them. Come here! Go away, you silly birds.
Silly birds? How dare they?
We are the seagulls, and we guard the snow line.
They got by us.
That's because you're a silly bird. You're a silly bird.
Wonderful here? Don't you ever get any snow?
No.
At least not when spring has come.
Really?
Come on, Lars. Come on, catch me.
Leah?
Here I am.
Leo!
Leo!
Here I am!
Ow! Oh.
Lars?
Oh.
Oh, there you are.
Oh, that really hurt.
Don't be angry with me, Lars. It's just really nice to be back home, that's all.
All right, I understand. Wow, that's a really big tree.
The cough doesn't seem like it's getting better. We have to do something. We promised Lars we'd look after them.
Lars?
Lars is going to be back soon.
Hey, I know what we have to do.
What's that?
We have to go to the cave that has the good air in it. That ought to help them breathe again, huh? That's what Sophocles said.
Okay. Just where is that cave?
It's not far at all. We have to bring them there right now, all right?
How are we going to do that?
Look, we just have to do it.
It's nice here. Just I can't see far. And it's probably hard to see the moon and the stars, isn't it?
The forest protects us, you know.
What else is the forest good for?
The trees are great for scratching on. And these leaves? You can use them as a hat. So when it rains, you just don't get wet. We have to find shelter. This is a lot better. And we have a nice place to lie down. Don't worry, it'll be over soon. The rain around here never lasts long.
I am so happy that you are finally home. I was beginning to think that you were never coming back. Where were you?
I was in the poacher's camp, but Lars saved me and his parents were kind enough to give me shelter during the winter. They're white bears and they're really nice bear parents. I stayed with them this whole time until the spring came and I could come back home again.
Are you talking about that little white fella who was with you?
Right, that's my friend Lars, the little polar bear.
You said a polar bear? Seriously? I don't think I've ever actually seen a real polar bear before. I don't see him anywhere.
Oh.
Where did he go to?
Lars! Hey, Lars, come on out, you silly polar bear. Come on, my papa didn't mean to scare you like that.
That's your papa?
Papa, this is Lars.
So that's what a real polar bear looks like. Interesting. Actually, he looks just like other bears.
Oh, Papa, don't. Stop the growling.
But, Leah, I'm not really angry. I like your Lars. And besides, a bear is a bear, no matter whether he is white or brown.
That's exactly what I think. Plus, the polar bears were very nice to me.
All polar bears?
Sure. But one in particular. You, Lars, he saved me. And now we have to help him with our honey medicine.
Oh, Leah, you didn't really tell him about our honey medicine, did you? That is our special secret.
I don't want to keep any secrets from Lars. His parents are sick, and the only thing that can save them is the honey medicine.
Indeed. Well, in that case, we have to help. but I believe we're out of it.
Well, then we're gonna have to make some more of it. Lars' parents really need it.
Mm-hmm. Whoa!
Up there is the only place that has fresh honey. Without that, there is no honey medicine. And only little bears like you can get it out of there.
Lars, have you ever climbed a tree before?
All the way to the top?
Sure. It's time you learn.
Look.
Wonderful.
My, I've never seen anything like it. It's beautiful.
This cave is an ancient secret for seals like me. This air heals everything. Really. You gotta take a deep breath. Try it.
Oh, Mika, I can actually breathe clearly again.
That's great.
Yeah, that's it. Keep it going. Do it like this. In, out. In, out. In, out. In, out. In, out.
Huh? You have to protect your eyes with one of your paws and reach in with the other one. Go on and try to get all you can. Hurry up while the bees don't know what's going on yet.
Leah, is this thing a bee?
Ow! Oh, Lars!
Enough now. Come on down. I'm going to go home and prepare everything.
Oh, I hope the bees are not very angry with us. Uh-oh, they're angry. Lars, come on. Trap, Lars, trap!
I wonder where the children are.
Papa, we're here.
We have the honey, but it was really hard to get.
Good. Now all we have to do is refine the honey.
Refine it?
Sure.
Huh?
According to Papa's old brown bear recipe.
Leah, help Lars and teach him what he needs to know in order to make the medicine.
We need the herbs with the sticky leaves.
All right, the ones with the sticky leaves.
Now, the herbs.
Now for the most important ingredient.
What's that?
The first morning dew. You need to collect it from these leaves early tomorrow morning and make sure that you get it before it evaporates.
Yeah, right. That's what we'll do.
It's important. If you oversleep, then the honey medicine won't work.
Don't worry, Papa. There's no way we'll oversleep.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, come on, we have to hurry now.
Yes, that's it. Yep, that's our secret honey medicine, which isn't so secret.
Wait for me!
Come on, let's go out to the snow line.
How are we supposed to find the snow line?
It's very easy. We just have to follow the seagulls.
Are you ready to go on your trip, Lars?
Yeah, sure.
Then put this around your neck.
What's that?
We're not exactly sure what it is. The humans left it behind, and with it, you can easily carry the honey medicine. Just watch out that it doesn't slip off from around your neck. Leah will accompany you, but only as far as the snow line.
I can find my way home from there by myself.
Give my regards to your parents. And invite them to our Big Bear get-together.
Big Bear get-together? We'll be there. Thank you for everything.
Have a safe journey.
Hey, it's Greta and Pete.
Oh, what are you doing here?
We're guarding the snow line!
Yeah. But the snow line is not a real line that has to be guarded. Sometimes it's here, sometimes it's there. And if the sun is shining, the line can simply melt away.
This is the shortest way back. We can get to the other side by jumping on the rocks. Come on, Lars.
All right, coming.
Lars! Lars!
Oh, no. Leah, the medicine.
Quick, Lars. We have to try to catch the medicine before it goes over the falls. Watch your step, it's slippery. When the barrel comes down, all you have to do is catch it, okay?
There it is!
Okay, catch it!
Oh, that was lucky.
There they are! It's them! They're coming! Lars and Leah!
Lars?
Leah! Lars!
Lars!
Greta!
Lars!
So how are my parents?
They are very close by. Robbie is looking after them. Come on.
Now we'll get the honey medicine and everything's gonna be all right.
They're coming! They're coming!
Lars! There you are!
Oh, we've been waiting for you.
Leah, bring the honey medicine quick!
Here it is.
All right, then. Who wants to be the first?
Mika. He is sicker than I am.
Okay, then bend down here, Papa, so we can give you the medicine.
That stuff is very good.
This is delicious. I'm already feeling a lot better. This scarf is getting too warm for
Hooray!
Me.
Hooray! Hooray! They're better!
Yeah.
Lars and Leah healed them with the honey medicine, see?
Yeah.
Have a safe trip home, Leah.
Until the Big Bear get together.
I want to come too.
A snow goose at the bear get together? I haven't heard of such a thing, have you?
Well, maybe this one time we'll have to make a small exception. After all, Peeps did such a great job in looking after us.
Peeps has to learn how to cuddle like a polar bear.
What does that mean?
Everybody cuddles together.
Okay, but no squishing.
Hey, Lars, come in the water.
Later, maybe.
Hey, what are you doing?
Flying is great. You know, Robbie, sometimes I'd like to fly in circles like that.
Look, Lars, a circle. Watch me, watch me. I'm going in circles, too.
Sure, that's a circle, but look how the seagulls are doing it. They hardly move their wings, yet they fly. I sure wish I knew how they did it.
Well, I hope you have fun flying.
Is a research ship. Humans do the strangest things there, but all in all, they're okay. They aren't hunters or poachers, and somehow they managed to save me.
What do you mean?
That's a long story. Let's see. It started a long, long way from here. The air was nice and warm with beautiful smells, and I flew so far out onto the ocean as never before. There were many other birds and a ship, a tanker ship. I felt like taking a nosedive into the water, and then I dove, stupid me, directly into the black water behind the tanker. Oh, I had already heard about this oil, but I didn't think it would be like that. It glued my wings stuck. I couldn't fly very well. The oil weighed my wings down. I just barely got out. What a relief to get into the clear water. At least I could swim again and even dive a little. With every dive, some of the oil disappeared, but whenever I tried to fly, I noticed that there was still too much on my wings. Finally, after many attempts with no success, I managed to fly a little higher.
but only to fall right down onto the research ship. I landed in a basket the very moment when the tanker ship passed us by. The oil spill was directly below me. But I was saved.
Hey, Lars, where have you been? I thought the ship got you for sure.
No, no. Yuri's telling us his story.
Who or what is Yuri?
Yuri is a puffin.
The wind managed to dry my wings. I was saved, and I started to feel strong again. When suddenly, the ladder moved. That thing just basically threw me in the air, and then I felt the oil again. I made one last effort and flapped my wings to find a better place, high up on the mast. Much, much higher.
Look, I can do it! I can do it! I'm finally flying! Yuri is telling us a story about flying. Who or what is Yuri?
Peeps, Yuri is a puffin.
I stayed up there for the rest of the trip. I didn't try to fly very much, but I felt better every day. Some days, I would see land, and then I would try to fly again.
Easy now. That's it.
I thought those researchers were pretty strange. They caught fish and let them go again. They liked to throw unusual things in the ocean, and they never saw me. Then, one day, the humans got very excited. There was land in sight. Ooh, when I saw the White Mountains, I knew I'd be home soon.
And then, he almost fell on my head.
What are we going to do now?
We'll help Yuri be able to fly again.
Yes, like this. First, we have to get his feathers really clean. But how are we supposed to do that?
I have an idea. Huh? You can clean anything with snow. It doesn't work. It's not coming off.
Maybe we need to rub Yuri on the ice like this. Roll around, Yuri. Look, just like me.
This sure is a lot of fun.
It's not working.
If cold stuff doesn't work, warm water might do the trick.
Warm water?
We don't have warm water. Everything here is cold.
Yes, but there is a place with warm springs. That's right, but only bears are allowed to use them. When we have a tummy ache, we go to the warm springs, and then we feel much better.
But only polar bears are allowed there, Lars.
And friends in trouble.
But what if the research ship is gone by the time we come back? I'm hoping it will take me home.
We have to do something, but what?
Well, we'll take care of the ship. We'll just have to make sure it stays right here until Yuri can fly again.
Yeah.
Then we're off to the warm springs.
Good luck.
Goodbye.
See you soon.
I have an idea. Greta, come on.
Anchor!
not moving at all.
Well, what do we have here?
Well, that's really weird. A snow goose can't be the reason it's stuck.
Wait, I'll give you a hand.
Let's go. Go away.
Did you see that? I distracted them. Good job, peeps.
Come on, give me a hand.
Huh?
We're almost there. You could almost smell the warm springs from here. Hey, what you doing?
One, two, cha-cha-cha. Cha-cha-cha, cha-cha-cha.
To walk in the snow, just do what I do. Come on, we have to hurry.
Cha-cha, cha-cha-cha, cha-cha.
Peeps, what are you doing? That tickles.
I can't remember how to fly. Was it like this? Or like this?
Do you want to keep an eye out on the boat?
Sure, that's what I'm doing.
Huh? Hey, what is that thing?
The researchers use that for flying and for watching us.
Have an idea. If they want to research us, then we'll show them something to research.
What about me? What about me?
You fly!
Yeah.
Find a way to distract them.
Okay.
Look how well our peeps can fly.
Yeah. Look at them go.
Hey, look at that!
You ever see that before?
Oh, look!
What is that?
Help! Help! Come and get us over here!
You guys were great!
You too, Peeps!
Huh?
Where do you think you're going?
None of your business.
Oops. Pardon me.
Just who or what is that?
That's Yuri, and he's a puffin.
That's weird. He's all slippery. Let me see.
Yeah, this stuff is really disgusting.
Hey, you guys, you better be really careful with that stuff. It's oil. And it never washes off. Ever. Yuri is covered in it. Let us by.
But where are you going?
To the springs. Where do you think? To the, oil springs. That's where all oil birds want to go, just like my friend Yuri.
You think what Lars said is true?
No, pause off. Would you cut it out?
What are you stopping for?
I was just wondering if you're sure that we're heading in the right direction.
Of course I am. I've been there several times. We're very close now. Are you coming, Yuri?
I don't know.
What's wrong?
Couldn't we just rest here for a little while? You see, I'm not used to being on my feet for an extended period of time.
Yuri, I promise. All we have to do is go through that thing, then we're there, okay? Come on, you're just a little scared because of all the shadows and the wind. But there's no need to be scared.
Lars, actually, I'm just a little afraid because of these icebergs. They're extraordinarily large. Suddenly, I feel so small. But you're right. There's nothing to be afraid of, is there? Lars, what is that?
Those are the guards of the warm springs. They guard the secret, the healing power, and they make sure only bears can enter the cave.
Wait, Lars, that doesn't work. I'm not a bear. They're not going to let me pass.
But I am a bear, and you're my friend who needs help. I hope they understand. Don't be afraid of the guards. They won't hurt you. Okay?
Afraid? I'm not afraid. I'm just a little tired.
I know, but the guards are tired too. Now, let's go in the cave. Here we go!
Into the cave?
Yeah, right. That's the only way to get to the hot springs, right through the cave. Are you ready?
No! Lars, what do you say we go back instead? Please!
Calm down now, okay? Oh, yeah, that reminds me. Someone once told me about the ghost who supposedly lives in the cave. But don't worry, my dad used to say, that's just a silly story. It's just the wind. It blows through the holes and the cracks.
Oh, I don't know, Lars. Are you sure that there isn't another way? I just can't do it. I'm far too afraid for this.
My dad used to say, if you don't risk anything, then you won't get anything. And that's why we're going right through the cave now. Hop on my back, and you and I will run right through it together.
Well, if you have the heart to do it, then so do I.
All right, ready? Get set. There wasn't anything to be afraid of, Yuri.
You were right. Thank you, Lars. I shall always remember everything I learned here today. Where there's no risk, there's no gain.
It's no big deal. Let's keep going. I can smell the springs. Huh? It's got to be around here somewhere.
Yuck, that stinks!
Ooh. Yeah, but Yuri, the stuff that stinks dissolves the oil. Trust me. What do you say? Watch out, the oil! That's it! fine real soon.
I've got to rest a bit, then I'll be okay. Thanks, Lars.
Oh. It should work now.
Yeah, turn up the gas or it won't come back up.
Good. Good, it's coming.
What are they doing?
I don't know, but I think it looks pretty funny.
I think I better go check it out.
Look, they let the balloon fly away.
Yeah, but why?
Supposed to be. We've got to go check it out.
Lars, watch out! There's always researchers near a balloon like that one. Please don't, Lars. We are not allowed to do that.
Oh, but this is great. Come here, I'll help you up. Come on now. Huh? What's that?
Don't, Lars! Please, don't!
Why not? Whoa! We're flying! This is... The entire world's below us. And I feel so free. We're flying, Yuri.
Ship is leaving. We couldn't stall it any longer.
Oh, that's not a problem now. I'm sure I can catch up with him. Thank you. Thank you, Lars, for saving me. And I thank all of you, too, of course. Thank you so much.
You stay here, peeps.
Have a good trip, Yuri.
Hey, look at me. I can fly. Do you see me? Huh?
All right, Super Peeps! Yeah, flying really is the best. Makes you feel so free. How do you do it without a balloon?
Like this. First, flap your wings and then go faster and faster. Now, everybody!
Flying!
Just give it a try. How can you tell that a dragon is sad? Have you seen an angel walk on her hands?